Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new here. My name's Amanda. I have an 8-month-old named William and a 3.5-year-old named Maggie. And today is National Lighthouse Day. So for this semester, since we're not really starting school yet, I have just printed out a calendar with a book of the day and all the national holidays that are kind of silly and fun. So we already did National Chocolate Chip Day, National Watermelon Day, and today is National Lighthouse Day. Oh, big airplane coming over. So naturally, we had to come and find a lighthouse, and we are at the historic Ponce Inlet Lighthouse Museum. So we are about to climb this huge lighthouse that's near Daytona Beach. So we took a little road trip over here. So we're just gonna
get to climb high.
You're gonna climb it. Maggie wants to climb it, and they said there's a lot of landings that we can pause in and take a little break. So I think we're gonna do that. We're gonna explore the historical buildings, and then we might go onto the beach after this or go on a nature walk. So we're just here to have a little road trip, a little exploration today. And we're gonna take you guys along with us. There's the lighthouse.
And now I'll climb to the very, very top.
This is the Woodshed Video Theater. Fell off. So we can go in here and watch this video to learn about the lighthouse. So they have a little video telling us about the Ponce Inlet Lighthouse. Okay. Some carpentry tools. Here's where they used to go to the bathroom. It's just a hole. I don't think you can see it. So this is where they went before indoor plumbing. You know we love a native plant garden. All this dune sunflower. Such a beautiful place. And there's the lighthouse. We're gonna go climb it. All right, I'm baby wearing William and he's 19 pounds. So this is gonna be the workout of the century. Are you ready for this? Let's do it. It might take us a while, but we're gonna try. I don't think there's anyone else really in here, so. We're gonna go as far as we can. Oh my gosh, we did it. I was trying not to look down because don't tell Maggie, but I have a fear of heights. It started to get to me a little bit, but she did it. I'm so proud of us. Now let's go outside and see the view. Maggie's so brave.
I was so brave.
You are so brave. You wanna keep going?
Wow.
Okay. Why are they yelling like that?
Making me.
Yeah. There's the bird sanctuary down there. Wow. Okay. Wow. There's some people kayaking down here. So windy! Ah! Look at the ocean. Okay, now we have to climb back down. How are we gonna do this? This is where they lived, those who kept the lighthouse. It's hard to see in there, but there's only 2 bedrooms. A front door on a modern bedroom could be unusual. Can you imagine some reasons why the keepers' homes were designed this way? So it's just 2 bedrooms. Or is this a parlor? This is the sitting room. Maybe on the back side is the kitchen. There's a piano, a sitting couch. Let's see if I can see over here. Another fireplace. Oh, you can't see in. Boo. Well, let's go around and see if we can look in the windows. I just love this brick. This really makes me want to travel to Colonial Williamsburg or something, go to Philly. I love history like this. So here's the other side of the bedroom. I like that quilt. Cannot go. Yeah, you can touch the wood. Just be careful. Ah, here's the kitchen. Aww. They have a little refrigerator, oil lamps, sideboard. There's the stove. Hard to see. So fun. I love this recreation. Maggie's first drinking fountain experience. All the drinking fountains have gone away since COVID, but they don't allow you to bring water into this section. So we're going to take what we can get. This is the Coast Guard radio beacon house and generator room. Oh, can you go in? Oh, nice. Come in, Maggie. It's air conditioned. She just wants water. Talking about World War II.
Can we go in
now? No.
Why?
Not any further.
Why?
Information about Florida and the war and World War II. A uniform. Wow, look at this. This is the actual lights used in the lighthouses. They're so pretty. I have never seen a lighthouse light up close. It's very big. I know we didn't really get to view the lighthouse light at that one. So at the beginning they had to keep a fire lit all night long, then they switched to candles, then oil lamps in the 1700s, and then these cool things, reflective lights, and then kerosene lamps, incandescent oil vapor lamps, and then finally electric lamps. And here's all the different kinds of lights. Wow, look at that Lewis lamp. Give you. It's got this really thick reflective glass. Very cool. Look at this super old anchor. What's in here? Oil storage house. Wait, did you say the lighthouse was fun?
Yes.
Oh, I'm so glad you did it. I think we're wrapping up our time at the Lighthouse Museum, and I think we're gonna go to the beach after this. But let's go inside and check out the gift shop. Okay, we gotta do a press penny. Ready? Now, can you reach that one? It says I climbed. Oh! It's cranking it right now. It's gonna press it in there. Oh. There it is. I climbed the Ponce Inlet Lighthouse. Lots of books and stuff. I like this art style. This is the only thing I want to buy in honor of the real cat that lived here, but Maggie doesn't want it. The nice cashier gave Maggie a certificate. Can I see it?
Yeah.
She even stamped it and everything, saying that she climbed all the stairs of the lighthouse. There it is. Look at Mama. Hey. William, did you find the treasure? Hi, Boo Boo. William's trying to walk. Take a big step. Big step, Bubba. William's eating leaves. So we just finished up our lunch. Now the last thing we're gonna do before we go to the beach is sit here and read our book of the day, Hello Lighthouse by Sophie Blackall. And then we will walk over to the beach.
Oh, you're supposed to walk over to the beach.
Actually, we may have to drive, you're right.
Why?
All right, we have found a beach. Unfortunately, we couldn't drive onto this beach. The other one that you could drive on was $20 and their card reader was broken. So we came back to this one, which was $10 to park. We have to walk, and I'm bringing this stroller. As you all know, strollers don't usually go on the beach, but I'm hoping it's a little packed down so we can drive on here. I saw another mom that had her stroller and she said it was okay because William's asleep. So he's in the stroller sleeping and Maggie really wants to come. So we are gonna try our best to see if we can make this work. Got a nice boardwalk. It's quite the walk, huh, buddy? You see any gopher tortoises in the sand?
No.
I see some cacti. Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
A little cactus. Yeah. Oh my gosh, that's tiny. Look at this walkway we just came upon. We're gonna go all the way out here first, and then we'll go on the beach. surfers and everything. Little man did not stay asleep. Poor guy. He's only slept like 30 minutes today. What is it? A buoy? What was it? A dolphin? Made a little beach setup. Got William a swim diaper on. Maggie's looking for shells. And I think we're just gonna walk out to the water. Are you feeling okay, William? I know you wanna put your feet in the water, huh? It's surprisingly very cold. Look at all this beach. There's the lighthouse. Went down and felt the water for a while. I forgot how difficult it is to bring children to the beach because of the sand and cleaning off the sand. And hey, Maggie's putting sand everywhere. What'd you find so far? Sea glass! So cool. You're doing so good, buddy. All right, baby William is so sad. It's time for us to go. Gotta get cleaned up and then get some dinner on the way home. Start our road trip back to the house. Woo! I wish we could take proper showers before we load up, but we're just gonna have to get through it being a little sandy. But I think we had fun. That was a really cool beach. All right, I got some coffee for the drive because it's late, but I'm tired. So I got a chocolate cream cold brew with peppermint instead of vanilla. Now we're in line to get some dinner and then we gotta drive home, and I'm dreading it because William sounds very cranky and I hope he doesn't cry for the entire ride. Hopefully he'll just fall asleep because he's exhausted and he had a really full day, but we'll see. Well, shoot, Maggie just fell asleep before we even got to the speaker box. So should I get her dinner? I don't know. All right, we are home safe and sound from our adventure today. I think we had a really awesome day. Maggie keeps saying how she was happy that she climbed up the entire lighthouse. But anyway, I just want to say thank you guys for coming along with us. Sorry for Maggie's obnoxiousness. She's hyped from her nap that she took at 5 p.m. Yeah, if you're thinking about going on an adventure with your kiddos and you're nervous about it, don't be. If I can do it, you can do it. Just get out there, explore your town, explore your surrounding areas, get outside, do all those things. The time is now. Don't wait. You need to just do things now and don't be afraid. All right?
I want to wait in the lighthouse.
You are not afraid of the lighthouse. Maggie pushed me to go up in the lighthouse, and I'm so glad she did because we had such a good time. So yeah, I just want to say thanks again for watching, guys. We'll see you in the next one. Bye.